mathematically discuss this idea. Suppose I have a sinusoidal waveform like A cos 2 pi ft plus theta. Now I want to sample of this particular waveform. Now this sampling is carried out at t is equals to nts. Before I touch on this particular issue again, let me address this one. This nts is nothing but n is the integer, n is the integer at which that particular sample is located. If suppose n is equals to 0, that is multiplied by ts, so at 0th position the sample is present. N is equals to 1, and if ts is equals to 5 milliseconds or 5 seconds, whatever it is there, then it is located at 5 seconds, then 5th second. Then if n is equals to 2, then the second sample is located at 2 is equals to ts, that is equals to suppose 5 seconds, then t is equal 2 into 5, that is 10th second. So the second sample is located at the 10th second. So when I obtain the digital waveform, then every sample is located at nth instant of its sampling time. That's why it is x of nts, it is denoted as. Okay, so with this note, let us move ahead. Suppose I have analog signal x of t is equals to a cos 2 pi ft plus theta. Now this signal is to be sampled into its digital form. Let me say that this signal is sampled at t is equals to nts. So I'll be replacing that t, which was earlier denoted as small t, now by nts. Now we know this relation that ts is nothing but 1 by fs. With this substitution, I can rearrange this equation as x of t is equals to a cos 2 pi n as it is, and this ts is now replaced as 1 by fs. So this is n by fs plus theta. Now let me again rearrange this one. If I rearrange the thing like f and f will be now suppose coming like this. So x of t is nothing but a cos 2 pi f by fs. This is capital F by fs, which is sampling frequency, which is the operating frequency of that switch. Okay, f by fs into n plus theta. So this ratio f capital F by fs is now termed as small f, which is the frequency of the equivalent digital signal, which is the frequency of equivalent digital signal that is obtained by sampling this particular analog signal. Now this frequency is known as digital frequency of the analog signal, of the equivalent analog signal, or most of the times it is also termed as normalized frequency. Now whenever we discuss this point, as such, when we go mathematically, we don't find any ambiguity with this time domain representation of the signal. Okay, but however, when we carry out this particular sampling, there are certain frequency domain ambiguities associated with it. Let us explain it, or let us explore it graphically. Now let me represent, suppose after sampling a continuous time signal, let me say that I'm coming across the discrete signal or the digital signal like this. Or to make it more clear, let me associate those sample at certain distances. Now suppose I want to draw, now suppose these are the samples of the discrete time signal, or these are the samples of digital time signal, digital signal that I have obtained by sampling the continuous time signal. Now somehow I don't have the original signal with me. During operation, or the transmitter might not have saved it for whatever reason, I don't have that digital analog signal with me. Rather, I only have the digital signal with me. Now I want to reconstruct back the analog signal from this part. Now, and I suppose, let us not talk in technical terms. Let me give you people the chance to draw the continuous time signal that passes through this these samples. Now see here, I can draw the signal like this also. Now this signal also has covered all the samples of the digital signal available, this sample is covered, this sample is covered, this sample is covered, and this sample is also covered. Now, the other person or the other receiver may reconstruct the signal like this. Now, if we observe it carefully, see, this sample is covered, this sample is covered, again this sample is covered, and this sample is covered. So this waveform also is covering all the samples of the digital signal. So this analog signal, this signal is also covering all the samples, and this signal is also covering all the samples. I beg your pardon in this case, because I have not drawn to the I have not drawn the diagram to the scale. Just for the understanding purpose, I am showing it to you. So, and this signal also is covering all the samples of the digital signal. Now, this particular signal is something which is having very high frequency, or it is having high frequency. How come it is having high frequency? Because the number of zero crossings here are more. Now, and here this signal is having comparatively less frequency. That means the zero crossing associated with this signal are less in this case. Now, this higher frequency signal and this lower frequency signal, both of them are equivalently represented by the same digital signal. By the same digital signal here. Now, I don't know which one is right or which one is wrong. Why? Because I don't have the analog signal with me right now. How can we decide upon which one is the correct representation of the analog signal that is present earlier? So this particular ambiguity is something that we are required to bother about. And that ambiguity is nothing but, it is called as aliasing, wherein the higher frequency, when I want to reconstruct back a particular digital time signal from its analog, when I want to construct back the analog signal from its discretized or digitized version, then this ambiguity comes into picture, wherein the higher frequency components, they take the form of the lower frequency component, and it becomes difficult to understand which part is the original, which part or which signal is the original representation of the analog signal. And that thing is nothing but, it is called aliasing. And our aim here henceforth is to address the concept of aliasing, and we are required to minimize this aliasing by applying proper sampling techniques and proper mathematical operations on the original analog signal while converting it into its digital form.